Welcome to Chapter 3, Fundamental Analysis. Now, as you already know what stock market is and how stock market works, the next pertinent question is that there are so many shares trading in the stock markets. Which one should I buy? I already have certain shares with me. How long should I hold them and which one should I sell and at what price? Now, this is a question which is answered based on three individual criteria. Now, this I would give you an analogy of a doctor. There is an allopathy, which is a field of science, and there is an Ayurveda, which is an ancient field of science. Both are related to medicine. But allopathy says that if somebody is suffering from headache, then you give paracetamol. That means every person who is suffering from headache, if he consumes paracetamol, his headache will go. But Ayurveda doesn't say like this. What Ayurveda says is that what medicine is applicable to you based on your ailment is not applicable to me based on my ailment. Because every body is different, every disease is different, and that is why ancient Ayurvedic Veds, or so-called as doctors, they used to make customized medicine for each patient after checking their pulse and diagnosing the diseases. Now, stock market investment is more like Ayurveda, not like allopathy. Lot of stockbrokers, they publish research reports and claim that you buy this company's share, it is going to go up from here. This bank is looking good, that IT company is fabulous, that infrastructure company is going to do well. However, the pertinent question here is that fine, these companies and these reports may be very valid, but are they valid for you? Do they fit into your criteria of investment? But you are going to come back and tell me, I don't know what is criteria of investment. How do I invest without knowing the criteria of investment? So I will tell you what are the criteria of investment. This flows from the concept of financial planning, where we say that there are three key criteria based on which investment decisions are taken by each individual. 1. Investment objective, 2. Risk appetite, and 3. Time horizon. Let us talk about each of them in little detail. Investment objective. Why are you investing? Are you investing just because you have extra money? Do you have a goal for investing? Have you set yourself a financial goal that you are retiring after so many years, so I want to save and invest money for my retirement, for my son or daughter's further education, for his or her wedding, foreign holiday, buying a new house? What is your goal? Your goal is also known as investment objective. Number 2, risk appetite. What is your ability to take risk? Now, some people are great risk takers, others are very conservative. I am not referring to your nature. I am saying this set of money which you are now planning to put in stock market, what is your risk appetite in respect to this money? Is it okay if you lose everything? Or you feel, no, this money is very important, I cannot lose it. That will decide your risk appetite. 3, time horizon. Are you in for a long term? Are you investing because 15 years later your daughter is going to go abroad to study? Or is it that 2 years later you are planning a foreign holiday? Now, this time difference will also influence the kind of stocks that you should buy. So, sum and substance of the whole story is that three criteria that each individual would have: investment objective, risk appetite, and time horizon, so far as investing is concerned. Now, that is the individual part of it. Now, let us come to fundamental analysis. What do you mean by fundamental analysis? Fundamental analysis is a method of investing or selecting stocks based on the financial performance of an enterprise or a company, assuming that you are going to be in for a long term. Because in the longer run, it is generally observed that the company's share price has some kind of positive correlation with company's financial performance. That means if year on year company is doing well financially, then we can reasonably presume that year on year the share price of the company will also go up. May or may not go up in direct proportion, because there are many short-term minor fluctuations which are completely unrelated to the company, and they may also affect the share price, like in general interest rates, inflation, economic situation, something affecting the sector, government policy, a quarter on quarter not good result. Anything can affect the share price in the short run. But if you talk of a longer term, then there is a positive correlation between share price and financial performance. So basically, fundamental analysis is looking at the financial numbers of the company over a period of time before arriving at a decision as to whether we will buy the shares of this company or not. Now obviously, this deals with past information, because company is providing all the financial numbers of its past. What about future? Now we are not investing for past, we are investing for future. We are investing today so that 1 year later, if the share price goes up by 20%, we will sell and make that money and take it home. So how do we come to know that what are the future plans of the company? How is company going to perform in the future? For this purpose, in a stockbroker's company or in a stockbroker's broking house, there is a guy called a research analyst. What research analyst does is, it goes and talks to the company, takes the interview of the management, tries to find out what are their future plans, then comes and analyzes the competitors, then tries and talk to the competitors, then understand how overall the sector is going to move forward. Then he will do a lot of research regarding Indian government, the general economic scenario, international taxation environment, and factor all of these things to come up with a very elaborate research report. In that research report, he will also prepare the projected financial statements of that particular company based on his assumptions. And once he comes out with projections, he is going to get the earnings per share of next 5 years. Now I know that this is an intelligent guess, but then it does give us a benchmark. So based on the benchmark created by him, we can come at a reasonable conclusion that if this company's share price today is at 100 rupees and if earnings per share for next 5 years is going to steadily increase, then definitely the price earning multiple will come down and we will see the growth in the share price of the company in the market. So this, in very short and sweet term, is called fundamental analysis. Now in a detailed program, we can go through each and every parameter, starting from the top line, going all the way up to return on capital employed, to identify how fundamental analysis is carried out and how this fundamental analysis can help you to take better financial decisions or better investment decisions regarding investments in the stock market. So I'm looking forward to seeing you in the next chapter, where we go and discuss something more exciting.